Amen. May we appreciate the present worship in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. We bless the Lord because of that session of powerful ministration. I believe that our life will never be the same again. Somebody say amen. Amen. How many people are ready to work? Hallelujah. Today we want to go to part two of the teaching of the other teaching we were making on this altar. And I told you, before you make any teaching to be profitable, there are four things you need to consider. Number one, careful tracking. You need to track the teaching with careful tracking. Number two, I said what? Undivided attention. Your attention should be here fully. Then number three, focused hearing. You don't listen to anything else. You hear the teacher of the word. Then number four, diligent submission. No matter what you know, no matter the knowledge you have acquired, you diligently submit to that teaching. That will become profitable to you. Somebody say amen. We want to share about the characteristics of a true son in the ministry. Are you writing? And what is ministry? I have already begun to teach. Ministry is the overflow of the life of God upon a man to a generation. That is ministry. Overflow of the life of God upon a man to a generation. Not to a church like this. Not to members of this number. A life of God on a man to a generation. That is ministry. Number two definition of ministry. Ministry is the ability or the capacity to trap the multifaceted dimension of God and express it. That is ministry. Hallelujah. The ability, the capacity to trap the multifaceted dimension of God and express it to a generation. That is called ministry. Praise the name of the living God. And I told you last time that there are people ordained by God to become fathers through the election of grace. By virtue of the sacrifice of alignment and the track record of obedience and loyalty and walking with God consistently, they have become patterns. They have become pathways to particular dimension of spiritual possibilities. Hallelujah. And also I told you that bodies come and go. Everybody look at me now. Bodies will come and go, but the systems of God continue. We see Elijah, before I begin characteristics of sons, Elijah, we see Jezebel threatened Elijah and he borrowed legs. Hallelujah. Elijah, the prophet that called fire down at Mount Carmel, borrowed legs and ran away. And we think the ministry of Elijah has disappeared. He went to heaven. Now we see 600 years to come down the line. John the Baptist come in the spirit and the power of Elijah. Hallelujah. And we see after his head was decapitated, we think it's over. When Jesus was praying, the Bible says he was transfigured before Peter, John, and James, and Elijah appeared. Bodies come and go, but the systems of God, they continue. Hallelujah. We see the same to Jezebelic system. Jezebel, alikuwa aliambia Elijah, sikiza hii, nitatoa kichwa chako kesho. Na kama sitatoa na miungu zangu, zikanidhuru. Tunamuona ya kwamba John the Baptist miaka sita anapokuja, msichana anadance mbele ya mfalme, anamwambia niitishe cha unataka, hata kama nusu ya ufalme, msichana anasema anataka kichwa cha John. Jezebel's system was still continuing. Hallelujah. Bodies will come and go, but systems of God will continue for generations. Hallelujah. And we said in the ministry, we have this order. We have father and we have a son. Hallelujah. And there are five kinds of sons. Before I give characteristics of sons, five kinds of sons. Number one, we have vagabond sons. If you are writing, write it. It's very powerful. Vagabond sons. Who are vagabond sons? Vagabond sons are sons whose every church belongs to them. Today they are in full gospel church. Tomorrow they are in a redeemed gospel. The other Sunday they are in transforming grace. The other Sunday they are in winner's chapel. Hallelujah. Vagabond. Acts chapter 19, verse number 13. And some of the Jews that were vagabond, Hallelujah. They went to cast out demons, and they were seven sons of Sceva. And the demon undressed them, injured them. They went out running. Why? The Bible says, Kiswahili nasema, hey, tukikwenda Kiswahili hapa, Acts 19 verse 13. Kuna baadhi ya Wayahudi wa kutanga tanga. Kuna washiriki wa kutanga tanga. And I pray for you, by the grace on this altar, you will not become vagabond in the name of Jesus. You will settle and be established as a daughter or a son in this altar. Number two category of sons. They are called prodigal sons. Prodigal sons. Prodigal sons are those sons who seek independence from the father. Hallelujah. Nasema, hapa siwezi kaa chini Apostle Wycliffe, tena nianzishe huduma yangu bila baraka yake, bila sending off ya baraka. The prodigal son in the book of Luke chapter 16 or 15 hapo, aliwacha boma. Akaenda nchi ya mbali, njaa ikakuja, akaanza kula na nguruwe. Lakini akakumbuka jambo moja, kwa nyumba ya baba yangu kuna wajakazi wanakula na kusaza, na mimi nateseka. I will go back to the house of my father. Na aliporudi pale mavazi ilibadilika. Aliporudi pale pete kwa kidole. He was connected back to the resources. May you not become a prodigal son. Come back to the house of the father. Hallelujah. Number three, we have rebellious sons. Rebellious sons are those who seize opportunity to replace the father. If we read the book of 1 Samuel 15 verse 6. 1 Samuel 15 verse 6. 2 Samuel 15 verse 6. 2 Samuel 15 verse 6. And Absalom stole the heart of all of Israel to himself. He stole the hearts. He stood at the gates and told the people, behold, my father is very old. He has commanded me to be here to receive gift on his behalf. He stole the hearts of all the people of Israel. Rebellious sons. Hallelujah. Wanaiba mioyo ya watu. Wanapaka watumishi wa Mungu matope. Wanaongea kinyume chao. Watu wanawaamini. Wanatoka na wanaanza rebellious ministry. Hallelujah. Rebellious sons. Then we have number four category of sons. Materialistic or malicious sons. Those who come in the ministry for the sake of gaining substance, financial, hallelujah, assistance from the church. They don't come to benefit from the ministry of the word, but they come with an intention of getting what the father has in possession. And we see Gehazi, he went and took the silver and the gold that Naaman was carrying. And Elisha told Gehazi, my son in the ministry, do you not know that when he went and took the silver, my spirit was with you? And the leprosy, 2 Kings chapter 5, verse 27, the leprosy of Naaman shall cleave unto you and your seed forever. They are malicious or materialistic sons. Then the last category of sons that I want you to become, they are called true sons in the ministry. I want to begin at that particular point. Hallelujah. What are the characteristics of what a true son or a true daughter in the ministry? Number one is what? Sons, they are loyal to their father. If you are writing right, loyalty. Loyalty. Sons are loyal to the father. A true son is loyal to the father. And let us read 1 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 17. I want to go very fast because of our time. 1 Corinthians chapter 4 verse number chapter 4 verse number 17. The Bible says, tusome verse 15 in the letter ladha mzuri. For though you have 10,000 instructors in Christ, yet you have not many fathers. For in Christ Jesus, I have become what? I have begotten you through the gospel. This is Apostle Paul, who was given the whole counsel of God, and is telling the church that though you have 10,000 instructors in Christ Jesus, yet you have no many fathers. I became your father because I have begotten you through the gospel. Then verse 17 is saying something. For though you have for this cause I have sent unto you Timothy, who is my beloved son, who is faithful in the Lord, and who shall bring into remembrance of my ways, which be in Christ, as I teach everywhere in every church. Number one, Timothy was beloved son. Number two, he was faithful in all the ways of his father. And the father had the audacity or the fortitude to what? To recommend him to other people, that he will remind him of his nature of life to everybody. Can God find such a person? Anaweza jivunia kwa huduma. Ya kwamba ukisimama hapa, watu naona Apostle Wycliffe. Hallelujah. Ukisimama hapa, wanaona Pastor Dora. Because you are faithful and you are beloved son. Hallelujah. You can be a regular church attendee. You can be a good Christian, but you have not become a son in the ministry. Hallelujah. You can be a good Christian. You speak in tongues. You pray for hours. You quote scriptures. A regular church attendee. You don't miss even one Sunday, but you have not become a son in the ministry. I recommend to you, Timothy, my beloved son. Faithful in all my ways, he will bring to your remembrance of everything I've commanded him. Hallelujah. Meaning number one characteristic of a true son is loyalty. And man of God in the ministry, we don't go for people who are more gifted. We need to go for those people who are more loyal. It's not about the gift upon a man. A gift, you can have a gift but you lack a fruit. Hallelujah. It is about loyalty. The most loyal is the more what? To be used in the work of ministry. The most trusted. Hallelujah. Not the gifted one. Even Lucifer was gifted. Read your Bible, Ezekiel 28 verse 12. Read the book of Isaiah 14 verse 12. Thou art anointed cherub. You are covering the mountain of God with praise. Until iniquity was found in you and you are put down. Oh, thou have fallen and have been brought abomination to the kings of the earth. He was anointed. He was gifted. He could sing until the host of heaven worshipped God. Don't be deceived with gift. Look for loyalty. Hallelujah. Number two characteristic of a son in the ministry. These things will help us. Hallelujah. Sons resemble the father. Wana ufanana baba yao. Hallelujah. Son resemble the father. Hey, mbwa inafuata umbo ya mama yake. Wenye waelewi hiyo lugha yetu ya Nigeria. Hallelujah. Sons resemble. There must be resemblance. There must be characteristics of Apostle Wycliffe in you to qualify you are a true daughter or a son in the ministry. Can we go to work? Hallelujah. Are we ready to work? The book of John chapter number 4, verse number 8. Hallelujah. Let us begin from verse number 6. John chapter 14, verse 6. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man can come to the Father but through me. And Philip asked Jesus, show us the Father, and it shall be sufficient for us. And Jesus replied, Philip, if you had known me, you had known my Father. Hallelujah. And he told him, verse number 9, Philip, you have been with me for long, and yet you don't know me. Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. Somebody clap to Jesus. Hallelujah. Let me read it with my version so that we may go to another level. John chapter 14. John chapter 14. Verse number 6. The Bible says, Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. If you had known me, listen to these words. They are very powerful words. A very graphical picture. This is what reflection principle in the ministry. If you had known me, you should have known my Father also. And from henceforth, you shall know him. And because you have seen him. Then verse number 8. Philip said unto him, Lord, show us the Father, and it shall be sufficient for us. Verse 9. Jesus said unto him, I have been with you for so long time, yet you have not known me. Philip, he that has seen me has seen the Father. And how say thou, show us the Father? True sons or true daughters in the ministry, they resemble their father. A sanctified priest result or culminates to a sanctified congregation. Hallelujah. Somebody have not heard that. A sanctified priest culminate to a sanctified congregation. If you have been with me and you don't know the Father, whoever has seen me has seen the Father. Not shaving the hairstyle of Apostle Wycliffe to resemble him. Si kushona suti na fanana kama yake. Si kunua kiatu na fanana kama yake. Hallelujah. Is doing what you see your pastor doing. Pastor is praying. Are you praying? Pastor is available in the ministry. Are you available? Pastor is committed. Are you committed? Pastor is a giver. Are you a giver? Hallelujah. A son will resemble the father. Wakati tuko fasting, ndio kuna mahindi msoko mzima, barabara wanakula. I am a daughter of Pastor Wycliffe. Kuna mahindi msoko mzima kwa barabara. Siku tuko fasting. Nakula shtata. Ngina kuna mandazi. Wanasema hiyo ni tabia mbaya huko Kayole. Bwana asifiwe. Hallelujah na Kariobangi. A son will resemble the father. Hebrews chapter 1, verse number 3. Him being the what? The likeness of his glory, the express image of his person, upholding all things by the word of his power. Jesus is the what the duplicate of God. Hallelujah. Hebrews chapter 5, verse number 8. Though he was a son, yet he learned obedience by the things he suffered. And having been perfected, he became the author of eternal salvation to them that believe in him. Jesus was serving on earth in the capacity of a son. He was honorable to the Father. He resembled the Father. John chapter 5, verse number 19. A son can do nothing except what he sees the Father doing. Hallelujah. John chapter 5, verse 19. Mwana hawezi kufanya kitu ila kile anaona baba yake kitendo. Naona watu nafanya mambo na shangao wanafanya mambo gani? Bwana asifiwe. Unapata mtu ameoa wanawake mlolongo ya wanawake vile pasi nasema. Na ukiangalia Apostle Wycliffe ana mlolongo ya wanawake. Na shangao huyu alitoa wapi character? Wewe unatembea tu vizuri hivi. Look at me somebody. I like demonstrating. Unatembea tu vizuri hivi. Alafu nazaa mtoto anatembea hivi. Nauliza mke wako na huyu alitoka wapi? There are some kind of members in the church, they don't reflect the character of their men of God. Oh, may God give us the grace. Hallelujah. May God give you the understanding. Sons and daughters will resemble the Father. Resemblance. There must be resemblance to show that you are a true son. Number 3, characteristics of a true son or a daughter in the ministry. Sons, they are supposed to be willing. Hey, this is very powerful. Holy Ghost, hallelujah. They need to be willing to be bathed into the philosophy, the doctrine, the standards, and the vision of the ministry. And to catch the spirit operating in the house. Hallelujah. That is another number 3 characteristic of a true son. You need to have the willingness to be bathed into the philosophy, doctrine, vision, pattern, standards of the ministry and catch the spirit flowing in the ministry. Bwana asifiwe. Our pastor anakuwa teacher of the word through the gift of revelation. Na wewe unakuja hapo kwa madhabahu, na unaanza kushika masikio, unaanza kutoa unabii. Sema ukiruka mguu mmoja hivi, wanawake watatu wasimame. Nasimama line. Nasema malaika wa red simama hapo, green wa yellow. That is not, you need to be bathed into the spirit flowing in the house. You don't need to ignite strange fire. Sons of Aaron, they ignited a strange fire and they were slain by God. Bwana asifiwe. You need to be ready to be born into what? The philosophy, standards, doctrine, vision, pattern. Hallelujah. Of the Father in the ministry. And we see in the book of Numbers, chapter 11, verse number 25. I don't have time to read. Hallelujah. Numbers 11 verse 25. The Bible says, and Moses complained to the Lord, this work of ministry have become a burden. Am I their father or their mother? Did I give birth to them? Why are they telling me water, water, food, food, quails, meat? And God told him, go and look for 70 elders and bring them in the assembly of the Lord. And it shall come to pass, I'll come in the cloud And I'll take the Spirit upon Moses, and I'll divide upon them, and they'll be able to help you in the administration of that ministry. Look at me, everybody. God did not take the Holy Spirit from heaven, another one, and put on the 70 elders. No. He took the Spirit upon Moses. Hallelujah. And he divided upon the 70 elders. And they did not become apostles. They did not become teachers or evangelists. Moses was a prophet. They prophesied without stopping. You need to flow with the Spirit in the house. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the living. Listen to this. This is a shocking revelation to you. That one man was carrying a dimension that could adequately satisfy 70 men, but he was just quiet. But when it landed upon the 70 men, they could not keep quiet. They began to prophesy. And there were two men in the camp called Eldad and what? Meldad and Eldad. They prophesied until Joshua began to complain. Stop them from prophesying. Hallelujah. You need to have the willingness to be bathed in the vision, in the pattern, in the what? Philosophy, doctrine, and the standards of the Father. And catch the Spirit flowing in the house. Banasifiwe. There is a mystery in the kingdom called the mystery of impartation. Mystery of impartation. Hallelujah. What is impartation? Impartation is transference of dimension of spiritual possibilities from one man to another. Hallelujah. An impartation is one major way God uses to transfer anointing and grace in the ministry. You need to have the willingness to be bathed. Hallelujah. Number four characteristic of a true son. Sons support the vision of the Father. Hallelujah. Now, Pastor Felix, Second Kings chapter 6, verse 1. I'm rushing because of time. Sons support the vision of the Father.
Amen. Second Kings, are we there? Chapter 6, verse 1. The Bible says, and the sons of the prophet said unto Elisha, behold now, the place where we dwell with you is too small for us. Let us go, we pray you, unto the Jordan, and take there every man of beam, and let us make a place there where we may dwell. 3. And he answered, go. And one said, be content, I pray you, and go with your servants. And he answered, I will go. So he went with them, and when they came to Jordan, they cut down woods, but one was cutting down a tree, and the axe fell into water, and he cried and said, alas, master, for it was borrowed. 6. And the man of God, said, where did it fall? And he showed him the place, and he cut down a stick and cast into in there, and the iron did float. Amen.
Now, if you have missed everything, don't miss this shocking revelation. This is the prophetic ministry of Prophet Elisha. He was having a school of prophets. Hallelujah. And the Bible says the house was too small. Hallelujah. Oh, the Holy Ghost was stirring me when I was coming to this place. That the house is too small. Listen to me, somebody. Child of God, listen to this. Elisha is having anointing to raise the dead. Elisha is having anointing to cleanse the leper. Elisha is having the anointing to part the Jordan. Elisha is having the anointing to open the womb of the barren woman to get children. Elisha has got the anointing that even his bones were able to resurrect somebody who was dead, thrown to his tomb. He was heavily loaded with anointing. But the expansion of the ministry, the advancement of the ministry was resting in the power of the sons of the prophet. Oh, somebody say hallelujah. It was not the responsibility of Elisha to extend the tent. It was the son of the prophet to get the revelation. The man of God is carrying the anointing. He's having the favor, the wisdom of God to reach people globally. But the house is small. Even if we don't have the axe, we shall go a step forward of borrowing the axe to cut down the big number that we may expand the house of God. Oh, somebody say hallelujah. Wakaomba shoka, wakakata miti, na wakikata miti, shoka ya kuazima ikaanguka. I want to tell you, whatever you give to the work of God, it cannot be lost. Hallelujah. Whatever you put in the house of God can never be lost. The man of God said, where did the axe head fall? He threw a stick there and it floated back. That tithe you are giving, hallelujah, that offering you are giving, that commitment of partnership you are giving, it can never be lost. It will come back to your hands. Can I get a believer in the house? You are complaining, man of God, I am a tither, I am a giver, but there is a contradistinction between my expectation and my experience. I want to tell you, whatever you give to God, it will come back to you in a double measure. Somebody clap to Jesus. Sons, they will support the vision of the Father. Amen. Listen to this. The church can be struggling, and we have potential people that can solve particular needs, but they are in the house of God, but they are passive. Hallelujah. There are things we pray for. Write down this. There are things we pray for, and there are things we take responsibility, commitment. Even if we sit here from morning to evening praying and fasting for electricity bill, tutamaliza na token itaisha itazima. Mungu anasema thank you for prayer, but my principle cannot be broken. Hallelujah. There are things we need to wake up to our responsibilities and fix it even without apostle knowing. Hallelujah. Sons of the prophet, they understood their father carries dangerous, intoxicating anointing. Let us make him his work to be easy, to minister to the people. In the school of the prophetic, they borrowed even the axe. Panasifiwe. Mta naendanga Fuliza. Mta naenda Faulu. Mta naenda Kenya Women. Anaenda kuwazima kwa ajili ya school fees ya mtoto wake. What about the work of God? Unaweza kosa but unaweza kuwazima ili kazi ya Mungu ipanuke, and whatever you put in the house of God, it will come back to you in the name of Jesus. Luke chapter 6 verse 38, give and it shall be given to you, a good measure, shaken, overflowing, that you give to men, so shall men give back to your what? To your bosom. It's a principle. Hallelujah. Son, support the father's vision. Before I finish on that point, number two illustration, Exodus 17 verse 8. Exodus 17 verse 8. This one is a very dangerous revelation. Dangerous revelation. Exodus 17 verse number 8. The Bible tells me that Amalek came to fight against Israel. And Moses was commanded by God to climb on the mountain. Hallelujah. Not to fight with the enemies. Listen to this shocking revelation. But to lift up his hands from morning till evening. And the Bible says it came at a particular juncture that the hand of Moses were heavy from morning to evening. He could not sustain the capacity to raise his hand in the air for the whole day. And the Bible said the son of the prophet called Hur and Haron, they took a stone, a comfortable chair like this, and they put for Moses, and he sat there. Then they lifted his hands from morning to evening. Listen to me, people of God. They are people of flesh and blood, but they are not just bodies. They are systems of God for expression in a generation. Inaonekana Aaron alijaribu kuinua mikono yake. Alipoona Musa mikono imechoka, akainua zake. Nothing happened. Hura akajaribu kuinua mikono zake, wanashindwa. Na Musa wakijaribu kuinua inarudi chini, ushindi unapatikana. Wakagundua is not about lifting up hand. This man is a system of God per time to control victory. Our secret of breakthrough is in this man. He's lifting up his hands. When his hands are lifted up, we enjoy victory. But when his hands go down, we are defeated. We deprive ourselves of the blessing. anointing of God. Sometimes the man of God is on the mountain lifting hands. Anasema Chairman Felix ndoa yake itasambaratika. Anasema Pastor Felix hiyo kazi itaisha. Anainua mikono mlimani. Anasema nyumba ya Pastor Seth hawatakosa school fees ya watoto. Ameinua mikono yake mlimani. Lakini nafika wakati mwingine mikono yake inakuwa mizito kwa sababu ya rent ya kanisa, kwa sababu landlord anamsumbua. Wakasema hapana, ushindi wetu uko ndani ya nabii wetu. Wakainua mikono yake juu, na walipoinua mikono yake juu Amaleka akashindwa. Somebody can hear you. Ushindi wetu uko katika huyu mwanamume. Haleluya. Wakati kanisa linang'ang'ana angalia maisha yako, utapata na kidheri ambao hauwezi kuafford. Lakini wakati kanisa linapeperuka, speakers zinanunuliwa mpya, kitana drums zinawekwa, microphones zinawekwa, utagundua maisha yako is progressing directly to the proportion of the extent the ministry is moving. Pasa kwa mlima nasema huyo mama sikufe na kansa. Huyo mama ndoa yake sisambaratike. Huyo kijana apate kazi. Huyo msichana apate mzee. Lakini kwa sababu mikono yake ni mizito, inafika wakati anachoka. Wakainua mikono yake. Son, support the vision of the father. Listen to this. And when Moses lifted up the hand, Joshua was fighting on the ground. Moses is lifting hand on the altar. But the one fighting is not Moses. The one fighting is Joshua. And the Bible says he overcame Amalek. Hallelujah. Support this vision. No matter the challenges you are passing through, no matter the untold predicaments you may be subjected to, no matter the mockery you may be within your proximity, support the vision. Your breakthrough is on the altar. Your next level is on the altar. Your marriage is on the altar. They lifted the hand of Moses, and the victory became spectacular, became notable. Nobody could ignore. He was a system of God. Hallelujah. Son, support the vision of the father. Support the vision. If you can buy 20 chairs, do it. Hallelujah. Your miracle is in that. Hallelujah. God does not use what you don't have. God uses what you have. The miracle of the oil of the widow, 2 Kings chapter 4. The son of the prophet had died. The woman was having debt. Elisha asked her, what do you have? A jar of oil. Shut the house. Pour in the tanks and commit the integrity of God. God will not use what you don't have. God will use that M-Pesa money you have. God will use that little money in your bank account for the miraculous to become a physical manifestation. Moses, what do you have? I have a rod. It was able to part the Red Sea. It was able, David, oh, I am not an experienced soldier, but I have a stone and a sling, and Goliath came down. Don't wait to get 1 million. Begin at your level. The fire will go in this life adventure is predicated by your quality investment in the kingdom. Oh, you will hear another day. The extent your life progresses or traject to another level is directly proportional or is predicated by your quality input or investment in that kingdom. Hallelujah. Son, support the vision of the father. Are we on number? Are you following? Number 5. Sons, they submit to the father's will. Hallelujah. Sons submit the father's will. Matthew chapter 26 verse number 39. It came a time Jesus saw the cup, it was so heavy. And I was asking myself what was in that foolish cup, that stupid cup, that Jesus, the light, the creator, the life, was afraid of it. It was carrying the present sin, past sins, and the future sins of humanity. It was a heavy cup for himself to carry. And he cried, Father, if it be my will, take this cup out of my way. Nevertheless, let your will be done. Hallelujah. Sons, They don't do their own will. They execute the will of the Father. Unakuwa anointed. Unadondoka na upako kama anointing oil yenyewe. Unaalikwa kwenda kuhubiri Mombasa. Pasa na kuambia apana usiende sande kuwa kaa chini. Na hiyo sande huta ubiri, huta program, huta interpret. Lakini anangalia that characteristics of submission. Wewe unaenda tu. Zema apostle anataka kutuzuilia. Hao ndio mafarisayo waingia watoke wanatuzuilia. Unaenda huko. Na nyongwa na mapepo. Napigia apostle ndio nakuja ku rescue. You submit the Father's will. Hallelujah. Listen to this. If you have submission, hata kama nikukosa ibada Jumapili, you need to be under the man of God. Unaandika tu message, man of God, please sitapatikana Sunday. I have a commitment kwa kazi ambazo siwezi patikana na sadaka yangu hii Sunday ni hii. It shows a depiction of submission. Hallelujah. Ile meni ya radi imeanza kupotea. Ile meni ya radi iko wapi hapa? Hakuna. Wewe unaenda tu shughuli zako. Pastor ataelewa. Pastor ajisort. Ni yeye aliitwa. Mimi sio pastor. Son, submit to the Father's will. Hallelujah. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Praise the name of the living God. Sons don't execute their own will but submit to the Father's will. When invited to minister elsewhere and the Father tells you not to go, submit. It will prove you are a genuine son or daughter in the ministry. You want to begin a particular business. The man of God anakuambia, no, don't do it. Utapata hasara. Jaribu kufanya hii ingine. Unaenda na invest. 400,000 kwenye investment fulani. Kwa zote zinapotea. Submit the Father's will. And you are victorious in it. Hallelujah. Then, as we are going to adjourn this teaching of first service, another characteristic of son, a true son, will abide in their house, in their home forever. Vitu liguzia sandes. Ndiyo? They will abide in their home forever. A son will abide. A servant will not abide. Sikia hii. Hii itakuwa mzuri sana kwa waimbaji na wachezaji vinanda. Lakini, acha niionge. Bwana asifiwe. Kuna watu waweza kuja church paka pasta ashikwe mfuko, ampatie kitu. Ya kuja kanisani. Ndio aimbe. Ndio muone roho ametiririka. Ndio muone kinanda imecheza, imetoa chords zote minor. Augmented, suspended, diminished, minister Jesus God zote. Paka pasta kwa meweka mkono, kwa mfuko, ametoa 1K. Ndia patikane. Those are servants. Because the portion of servants is wages or salary. But sons, they don't need anything from the Father. Everything the Father has is theirs. Hallelujah. You come present, worship mapema. Ukona fair, huna fair, God will provide. Hallelujah. When mubiri aspina mapema, unapatikana. Kuna chairman Felix pengine anaitwa Uber. Pala tena pata 6,000 Sunday. Anasema wacha ikae. Anapatikana kanisani. Hallelujah. I want to tell that's the victory we'll get. Abide in the house, the home. John chapter 8 verse 35. A servant does not abide forever in the home, but a son abideth forever. Praise the name of the living God. Kutakuwa na kashfa. Skandu itawekwa hili kanisa. Hautaondoka. Bwana asifiwe. Mchungaji atapakwa matope. Kanisa litawapatiwa jina mbaya. But it is your home. You cannot go out of it. Mchungaji atakukemea. Utasikia uchungu. Lakini hautaondoka. Because I am a son. A son abideth forever. Patia Bwana makofi ya kilo. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the living God. Bwana tukuzwe. Then as we are going to finish, a son covers the father's weakness. A son covers the father's weakness. Genesis chapter 9, verse number 20. And after the great flood, Noah became a farmer and akatengeneza vineyard ya mvinyo. Na the breach of righteousness, liwaambile sande ingine wenye walikuwa hapa, breach of righteousness. Alikunywa mvinyo ya nini? Vine. Mzabibu. Akalewa paka akalala uchi kwenye hema. Na Ham, mwana wa nani? Wanoa batimbaa akaona babaka amelala uchi hapa. Akaona. Instead afunike hata siangalia huko. Alitazama uchi ya baba yake na akaenda akaita ndugu zake wawili. Akawaambia, Shem, Japheth, baba yetu imagine amelala uchi wa mnyama. Imagine. yenda natuhubirianga angalicha ni mlevi babe ni mlevi chakari amelala uchi kwenye hema wao hakutaka kusikia hiyo mishene walimstop usiongee waliruna kitambaa kinyuma backwards read your bible they went backwards with the cloth and they covered na kamwambia you will serve your brothers bwana asifiwe Mungu anapokufungua macho kuona udhaifu wa kanisa haja kufanya kuwa advertisement agent haja kufanya kuwa magnification lens amekufanya intercessor wa kuombea udhaifu iondoke igeuke ifanyike nguvu ya kuokoa na kubadilisha watu transforming grace ministry in the name of the living God Bwana Yesu atukuzwe hallelujah funika uchi wa huduma weakness nakedness it can be in multifaceted dimension cover it and commit the integrity of God hallelujah mimi nakumbuka kuna wakati mwingine nilikuwa na uhubiri mahali crusade kama nimesimama chini bwana asifiwe mungu anafanyanga kazi kwa njia za ajabu na uhubiri na shout nimesweat hivi na hata watu kama wana ignore hata kusikia kuna mama mwingine akatoka tuko watu alikuwa kumbe ametoka America United States of America na alikuwa kwa hiyo area kashanga who is this young man preaching sema pastor tomorrow you can preach better ukiwa kwa platform usihubiri ukiwa chini how much is the jukwaa bwana asifiwe kamwambia it's about 40,000 alinitumia nikatuma hardware jukwaa ikatengenezwa Thursday Friday tulikuwa na uhubiri paka gari la police lilikuja tushikwe lakini injili iliendelea I want to tell you the ability of God manifests in man's availability. Be available in the house of God. Your miracle will be when you are available. Hallelujah. Cover the father's weakness. Cover the weakness. Kuna watu wengine wanakuwa kwa kanisa. Sikiza hii. Wako na uwezo wa kusupport church. Na kanisa inapitia storms lakini wako passive. Kwa nini? Upendo wa Mungu hauko ndani ya mioyo yao. Sikiza hii. Kings chapter 8 verse 17. 1 Kings 8 17. It was in the heart of my father David to build a temple for the name of the Lord. It was not in the pocket. It was not in the bank account. It was not in the surplus. It was in the heart. It begins with a mind posturity for you to be an addicted and committed giver. It was in the heart of my father David. 2 Chronicles chapter 29 verse number 4. Because of my affection for the house of God, I have taken from my proper mine of gold and silver to the construction of the house of God. Upendo wa moyo wangu umenisukuma kutoa kwa hazina yangu dhahabu na fedha kukamilisha nyumba ya Bwana. Bwana tukuzwe. Psalms 132 verse 4. Daudi anasema, sitaingia kwenye ikulu. Sitapanda kwenye kitanda changu. Sitapata usingizi kwa macho yangu mpaka nimchengee Bwana makao. Bwana asifiwe. God does not want you to be available in the ministry. God want you to be usable. Sio kama mtu umesikia hiyo apostle. God does not want us only to be available in the work of God. God wants us more than availability to be usable. Add value in the department you have been allocated. Bring a difference in the area you have been made a leader. God want you to be usable. Baneza tukuzwe. Sons cover the fathers. Weakness. And the last and not the least. Sons. Sons. Listen to this. Honor the father. Honor the father. Nilisoma vitabu mingi last Sunday. Start kufanya repetition. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 12. As I finish, somebody, everybody, turn to me with me. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 12. I beseech you, brethren, consider them who labor among you. Verse number 13. And esteem them highly that lead you in the Lord and have oversight over you. Is somebody listening to what I'm saying? Waje nisome message Bible. Message Bible itakushangaza. Inasema give them a bonus. Give them a bonus. Hallelujah. Ni vizuri kuwa unasoma translation mingi za Biblia. Don't just base on one version. Listen to this. Precious people of God, as we finish New Testament, the book of Thessalonians, chapter number 5, First Thessalonians chapter 5, verse number 12 and 13. Now, friends, we ask you to honor those leaders who work so hard for you, who have been given the responsibility of urging and guiding you along in your obedience. Overwhelm them with appreciation and love. Overwhelm them with appreciation, with love. 1 Timothy verse 17, Message Bible. Inasema hivi, give a bonus. Unajua bonus? Bonus ni ile kitu kwa kampuni unapatianga watu kila mwaka kwa kazi wamefanya mwaka mzima kwa uaminifu. Bonus. Kwa hivyo nasema, give a bonus to leaders who do a good job, especially the one who work hard at preaching and teaching. Give a bonus to them, to the leaders. Give a bonus. It means salary. The Bible says in King James Version that the elders who rule well should be counted worthy of double honor, especially them that labor in word and in doctrine. They should be what? Given double honor. Double honor is not bowing down before the man. It's not kneeling down. It's salary. Hallelujah. It's bonus. It's token. It's appreciation. Simama kwa miguu zako kwa jina la Yesu. Hallelujah. How many people are blessed up to that level? Sons in the ministry. Hallelujah. Radical sons. Hallelujah. I like that. Nikimalizia hii, sikiza hii. Paul alirecommend watu wengi kwa ministry kwa kazi wamefanya. Sikiza hii, itakuinua. Paul alipokuwa anamaliza apostolic ministry, kaanza ku make recommendation of the people alifanya nao kazi. Akafia kwa John Mark. Akasema, "Oh John Mark, you were afraid of the battle in front of me and you went another route. Ukaniwacha." Kuna watu kama washirika wa inayoko kanisa. Wakati kanisa liko na vita wana dodge. Bwana asifiwe. John Mark alihepa akawacha Paul peke yake kwenda vita. Aka recommend Demas. Akasema Demas left me in Thessalonica because of worldly pleasures. Kaniwacha kwa sababu ya mambo ya dunia. Na mipango ya kando, usherati, ulevi. Basi nakwambia wacha. Demas akaamua kuchagua mambo ya dunia akawacha Paul. Kukakuwa na mtu anaitwa what? Alexander the coppersmith. 2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 14. Akasema Alexander the coppersmith, you have done more evil to me. May God reward you according to your mischief. But when he came to Timothy, akasema to my son Timothy, 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 2, be strong in the grace of our Lord Jesus. And whatever you have heard from me in the hearing of many witnesses, commit to other faithful men that may remind other people. For I consider the unfeigned faith in you that was in your grandmother and your mother Lois. Hallelujah. He was faithful. He was beloved. Kuna walimwacha Paulo. Kuna walimwacha wakati aliwahitaji. Mpaka Paul akakosana na Barnabas. Kwa sababu ya John Mark. Aliogopa vita mbele. Lakini akasema Timotheo. Mwanangu mpendwa. Mwaminifu. Wakumbushe wote yote. Nimeweza kufundisha. Kama kuna mtu kama huyu inua mikono zako mbele za Bwana. Mwambie Bwana kabla sijapeana kipara sauti. I want to become a faithful son in the house. I gonna support the vision of the father. I gonna stand in the gap. When the ministry is passing through what raging tempest. When the ministry is passing through persecution, I gonna hold the hand of the man of God. I want to resemble my father. I want to go to another level. Somebody open your mouth. Don't close your mouth. Tell God, give me the grace. Give me the capacity. In the mighty name of Jesus.